So hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to the session of PIB 247 where we will discuss some more questions from the PIB news which are relevant for the ESI section of RBI Grade B and NABARD. But guys, before beginning the session, there is a good news for all of you who are preparing for UPSC. So we are starting with the new series of UPSC mains answer writing. In 1 week there will be a video, ek hafte mein ek video hogi jisme hum seekhenge how we can write a good answer. And tomorrow, that is on Saturday at 8 AM, I will bring to you a session in which we will discuss how we can write a good answer, what should be a good structure for a UPSC mains answer. So tomorrow 8 AM, please watch the session if you are preparing for UPSC. And now let's begin with the session. But before we begin, if you are coming here for the first time, do subscribe to our channel and press this bell icon. And you can also join this Telegram group for daily quizzes and other relevant information regarding the sessions. Alright, so let's begin with the session. And kal maine aapse ek question pucha tha, what is L1 in Aditya L1 mission? Aditya L1 mission mein L1 kya hai? Alright, so bahut hi kam logon ne answer diya hai. And kuch logon ne honestly ye bhi bataya hai that yes sir, we don't know about this, we are not aware about this. So L1 का मतलब मैं बता देता हूँ. L1 stands guys for Lagrangian points or the Lagrange points. Lagrangian points या फिर Lagrange points कुछ भी कह सकते हैं. These are the points between two body system in a space. कोई दो body system है, let us say sun and earth, and ये एक point है उनके बीच में, और ये वो point होता है अगर all the forces are balanced. So it is a point between two body system in space where all the forces are balanced between these two bodies. Now all the forces here means the gravitational force and the centripetal force. Alright, the gravitational forces between these two bodies and the centripetal force. I hope aapko in dono forces ke baare mein pata hai. So gravitational force or centripetal forces jo hote hain is point ke upar two body system mein balance hote hain in the space, and therefore these points are the most favorable position for a satellite. Agar kisi do body system ke beech mein hame satellite ko put karna hai, so L1 is the most favorable point. And between earth and sun, the L1 point between them is 1.5 million kilometers away from the earth. Earth se 1.5 million kilometers hai. And that is why this mission is named as Aditya L1, because in this the satellite will be placed at the L1 point between the earth and the sun. So I hope guys this L1 ka matlab is clear. And now let's begin with the very first question for the today. Under which scheme of the Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare, which is headed by Mr. Narendra Singh Tomar, Kar Nicobar and Nankauri group of islands in the UT of Andaman and Nicobar have got the large area certification. Now what is this large area certification? Let's talk about this and why it was in news, because Kar Nicobar and Nankauri group of islands in the UT of Andaman and Nicobar have got this large area certification. So as I told you that Kar Nicobar and Nankauri group of islands in UT of Andaman and Nicobar Island have become the first large territory to be conferred with this certification, which is known as large area certification. And about 14,491 hectare area in this UT has been identified as the organic under the large area certification scheme. Now this large area certification scheme guys is under the Paramparagat Krishi Vikas Yojana, which is to promote the organic farming in our country. Paramparagat Vikas Yojana humne kafi detail mein padha hai. So this scheme Paramparagat Krishi Vikas Yojana has the objective to promote the organic farming in our country. And under this scheme, this large area certification scheme is there. And under this large area certification scheme, each village in the area is considered as one cluster or the group. And all the farmers with their farmland and livestock need to adhere to the standard requirements, and on being verified they get certification of the large area certification after being organic banne ke baad us particular area ko large area certification ka jo certificate hai wo mil jata hai under the Paramparagat Krishi Vikas Yojana. And this certificate guys is in the form of a statement or a logo, and it is issued based on the FSSAI regulations of the organic farming. Certification is renewed on annual basis through annual verification by a process as per the process of PGS India. PGS stands for Participatory Guarantee Scheme, which is a component under the Paramparagat Krishi Vikas Yojana. Alright, so I hope guys this news is clear. And now let's come back to the question. The question is under which scheme they got this large area certification. So the name of the scheme is Paramparagat Krishi Vikas Yojana. Option B would be the correct answer. And now let's move ahead to question number 2. Which of the following public sector company has launched the first ever infrastructure investments trust? Now question for today. Aaj ke liye aapka question hai, because aap sabne finance padha hoga, since you are preparing for RBI grade B, so you must have prepared finance. So finance mein ek bahut important term hota hai jiska naam hai infrastructure investment trust. So you have to tell me in the comments what is the infrastructure investment trust, and if you don't know the answer, please write down that sir we are not aware, and in the next session I'll tell you the answer. All right, so you have to tell me what is the meaning of infrastructure investment trust, write down in the comments please. Now PGCIL, Power Grid Infrastructure, Power Grid Corporation of India Limited, has become the first public sector company. In fact, it is the first Maharatna to issue the first infrastructure investment trust to be launched by a public sector company. It owns, construct, operate, maintain and invest in power transmission assets in India. जो ये ट्रस्ट होगा, इट विल ओन, इट विल कंस्ट्रक्ट, इट विल ऑपरेट, इट विल मेंटेन एंड इट विल इन्वेस्ट इन द पावर ट्रांसमिशन एसेट्स इन द कंट्री एंड इट विल बी रजिस्टर्ड विद सेबी ऑफ कोर्स एज इनवीआईटी, इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर इन्वेस्टमेंट ट्रस्ट. द यूनिट्स ऑफ पावर ग्रिड इनवीआईटी आर प्रपोज टू बी लिस्टेड ऑन बीएसई लिमिटेड एंड एनएसई लिमिटेड, एनएसई इंडिया लिमिटेड, दोनों के ऊपर इसके जो यूनिट्स हैं वो लिस्ट होंगे. एंड इट विल बी द थर्ड इनवीआईटी आफ्टर आईआरबी इनवाइट एंड इंडिया ग्रिड ट्रस्ट टू बी लिस्टेड इन इंडिया. तीसरा इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर इन्वेस्टमेंट ट्रस्ट होगा ये आफ्टर आईआरबी एंड इंडिया ग्रिड ट्रस्ट, जो कि लिस्ट होगा इंडिया में ऑन बीएसई, ऑन आइदर बीएसई और एनएसई. ऑलराइट, सो दिस इज सम बेसिक इंफॉर्मेशन. द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट ऑफ दिस न्यूज गाइस इज दैट विच कंपनी, विच पब्लिक सेक्टर कंपनी हैज बिकम द फर्स्ट एवर पब्लिक सेक्टर कंपनी टू लॉन्च दिस इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर इन्वेस्टमेंट ट्रस्ट. सो द करेक्ट आंसर टू दिस क्वेश्चन इज व्हाट, ऑप्शन ए पीजीसीआईएल, विच इज अ महारत्ना कंपनी. एंड नाउ लेट्स मूव अहेड टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 3. The Chandler Good Government Index has been released by the Chandler Institute of Governance, which is an international non-profit organization headquartered in Dash. You have to fill this gap, where this Chandler Institute of Governance located. And guys, question number 4 is also based on Chandler Good Government Index. Now let's talk about this index first. So remember, India has been ranked at 49th place out of 104 countries in the Chandler Good Government Index. And this index, guys, is released annually every year by the Chandler Institute of Governance, which is an international non-profit organization based in Singapore. It is headquartered in Singapore. It has offices in other countries as well, but it is headquartered in Singapore. And the index classifies 104 countries. As I told you, out of 104 countries, India has been ranked at 49th position. And the index, guys, is focused on 7 pillars based on 34 indicators. And these are the 7 pillars, which are leadership and foresight, robust laws and policies, strong institutions, financial stewardship, attractive marketplace, global influence and reputation, and helping people rise. Now you must be wondering that what is the objective of releasing this index. So the basic objective, guys, of this index is to determine how good in a country is their governance. Ek desh ke andar jo governance hai wo kitni achhi hai, is cheez ko determine karne ke liye this index has been released. The objective of this index is to determine the quality of governance in a country. And these are some of the basic highlights. Finland has topped the list, followed by Switzerland and Singapore. Number 2 pe we have Switzerland and number 3 pe we have Singapore. All right. And performance of South Asian countries ki baat kare, so India, as I told you, 49th pe hai, Sri Lanka 74, Pakistan 90th and Nepal 92nd pe. 7 of the top 10 countries are in the Euro, and all the top 10 countries are the high income countries as defined by the World Bank, which means this report indicates that somehow governance is related to the high income. Good governance is related to the high income. Agar kisi desh ki income zyada hai, per capita income zyada hai, to wahan pe jo governance hai wo bhi achhi ho rahi hai, as pointed out by this index. And these are the top 10 countries. You can have a look here: Finland, Switzerland, Singapore, Netherlands, Denmark, Norway, Sweden, Germany, New Zealand and Canada. All these countries are the high income countries as per the definition of World Bank. All right. So this was about this news and question number 3 and 4. Let's come back to the questions. Headquartered in Singapore. So the correct answer to this question, guys, would be option E, Singapore. This Chandler Institute of Governance is headquartered in Singapore. And remember, it is an international non-profit organization. And question number 4 is, you have to consider the following statement regarding this index and identify the incorrect statements. India has been ranked at 59th out of 104 countries. No, India has been ranked at 49th place, which means this statement is incorrect. The index is based on 7 pillars with 34 indicators. This is absolutely correct. It is based on 7 pillars with 34 indicators. And Switzerland has topped the list followed by Finland and Singapore. No, Finland has topped the list followed by Switzerland and Singapore. This statement is also incorrect, which means the correct answer should be, guys, option D, only 1 and 3. Alright. And guys, that's it for the session today. I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. And don't forget about the tomorrow session of UPSC Mains Answer Writing Structure. Kal Saturday, subah 8 baje, aapko ye session join karna hai if you are preparing for UPSC. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.